Here we have for sale a very special piece of kit, and this is our 2016 on a 16 plate Volkswagen Transporter. This is the T6 Highline DSG Kombi. It is the 2-litre, 180 brake horsepower by turbo. But this van is anything but standard. So what we're going to do is have a little walk around in this particular video, have a look at the spec, but also the condition of this particular van. So first thing to do is to open up the driver's door and let's have a look here inside. We do also have, it's probably best if I open up the back doors as well, we'd have electric open and sliding doors on this van, both sides. And the first thing you'll notice is the lovely leather trim which is in this particular van. If we look on the driver's door, we've got electric windows, we've got electric heated folding mirrors, lots of little options that the previous owner has had here, like little cup holders here or there. We've got auto-activated lights and wipers. As you can see here, we have got multiple spare keys with the vehicle. And one thing to mention on this as well, if you look on there, you can actually open and close the sliding doors with the key. So if we use that, you can see there that that's opening the passenger door, and we can close that as well and close the driver's side door. So you can operate that all off the key, which is very, very nice. Mileage on this particular van, 44,308 miles. You can see we've got the nice leather multifunctioning steering wheel. So on the right-hand side here, this is where you can control the onboard computer. And then on the left-hand side, this is where you've got the volume controls. On that left-hand stalk as well, you can see there, that's where you've got the cruise control. One of my favorite features on the Transporter is the double adjustable armrests. So you can adjust them using the little roller under there. So you can have them at your desired height. Makes them very, very comfortable to travel in. Also, another unusual piece of spec on this particular van, the electric sunroof. Turn on the ignition here. We can turn the dial, which is just up there, and that will then, as you can see there, you've got an electric tilt and slide sunroof. Very, very nice to have and very unusual as well. While we've got the ignition on, we can have a look here at the Kenwood head unit. So you've actually got DAB radio on here, and we've also got inbuilt sat nav as well, as you can see there. More optional extras on this van. Heated seats. As I mentioned, you've got the electric doors, so you can actually control them off here as well. Air conditioning, you can see just behind there. We've got the heated windscreen. Previous owner has left these cradles in for an iPhone, so you can plug that straight in there as well. And before we go into the back, where you'll see lots of more additional spec, let's have a look at the service history. So we've got the nice service book here. And as you can see, the first part of its life, it's been service with VW. And then the last service then, which was at 42,000 miles, it's on 44 now, that was with an independent garage. They have ticked the touched belt yes there. So it looks like the timer belt has been done there on that. We obviously will double check before it leaves us. We've also got cab carpet with the overmats as well. Now, if we look just back here on the B pillar, you can see here that we've got this Eberspacher control, and this is for the heater, which is located underneath the driver's seat. So let's go around the van and let's have a look how that works. We can open up the doors as well. Looking at the front of the van, it's also a very nice bit of spec, probably one of my favorite pieces of spec to get on a new Transporter, and that is the LED headlights. The headlights on a standard Transporter are certainly one of the weak parts of the van, really does let it down, but these LEDs are fantastic. You've got a lovely daytime running light here, halo effect around the outside, and then as I say, these really bright LED lights there. Front fog lights, you've got the actually front parking sensors on this, which again wouldn't be standard. You've got the color-coded front bumper, these extra little trims here in the chrome to make it look very similar to a Caravelle. Wolf Race diamond cut alloys. These are the 18 inch Assassin alloys, as you can see there as well, wrapped in Dunlop tires. So all things, you can see that this has been a very well looked after and loved van. If we come around to the rear seats then, so you've got the 2+1 rear bench seat. Again, that would be an optional extra. Lovely thing with the 2+1, of course, you can use this seat independently to the bench there. So you can move it forward like that on the handle to give you access into the rear. Or alternatively, you can pull on this here. Not sure if I'm going to be able to do this with one hand. There we go. So you pull on that little tab down there, and that means you can fold the seat down flat. You can do exactly the same with the far ones over there as well. Now, if we look down here, you can see that we have got the split charging unit. So you can actually plug this van in via an external, traditional camping electrical hookup, and this is where all that is controlled. So you've got your lights here, you've got a pump, which I believe is for the heater, and then you've also got this Stirling Power products here, which that shows you voltages, etc. there as well. This is a light switch which controls all the extra lights in the roof, so you can turn those on and off. Very, very smart. You've got these extra reading lights here for your rear passengers, one on the other side there as well. And as you can see now in the rear, you've got this very, very nice carpet lining. So you've got carpet lining over the arches. You've got then got the lovely Alcantara, this sort of suede effect here, as you can see. You've got that on the side panels. So let's go around to the rear of the van. We can show you the spec there. You can close the door just by pulling the handle as well. And that will just lock automatically. As you can see here, we have the Kenwood reversing camera. As I mentioned, this is the bi-turbo 180 brake horsepower one. So we've got the carbon fiber effect rear bumper protector. We've also got rear parking sensors. Lovely Westphalia detachable tow bar. Spare safe just there to stop anyone stealing your spare wheel. If we have a look under here, if you can just see that, but there is your electrical hookup there. So if you were to take this camping, you can actually plug this van in. So that means you can plug into all of the sockets which you'll see on the van. You can plug into those without having to drain your battery. You've actually got a leisure battery there underneath the passenger seat as well. So if we jump into the back here, we can see that we've got proper RCD board there to be able to control your electrics. Additional speakers in the rear here, which do work very, very nicely. Another thing to mention is you can see that we've actually got these additional lovely curtains, which are on the side windows and also the rear tailgate. More additional lights there in the tailgate. They come on when you open up the tailgate. Some nice Fiamma pockets. So what the previous owner has done has put these extra points in the floor. So you can see there that they mirror the ones for the double seat. So you could put an extra double seat in the back of here to carry more passengers. So you could carry 7 passengers in here, or alternatively, you could change this into probably a rock and roll bed, and you're very, very close to having a camper already. But you've got lots, as I say, lots of controls here. As I say, things like the extra sockets, USB points, again, more things here to do with the electrical hookup and the charger. These plastic covers here, they cover the electric door controls. I say controls, the mechanism really. But what a spec on this van. It's really difficult to know if I've missed anything, but there's so much to mention. I don't think I've actually come across a van which has got this many extras on it. But what a lovely thing. It looks to me as if this van has been slightly lowered as well. It's sitting really nicely without being too low. I've driven it myself. It drives very nicely as well. As you can see, lovely service history, and as I said, what a spec, with the heater there under the seat, a 3-pin socket, you know, more USB ports. I believe I spotted another one here just on the side of the driver's seat, just around here somewhere. There, so you've got some more sockets just down there as well. So they really have kind of thought of everything when they've gone through this van. So if you'd like to inquire on what has got to be one of the best spec'd transporters we've ever owned, feel free to give us a call on either of the numbers listed there at the bottom of the sign. We can take cars or vans in part exchange, and we can arrange finance at very competitive rates, starting as low as 7.9% APR. If you'd like to know anything more about this spec, as I say, there's lots and lots here with, you know, the charging of the van, with the leisure battery, as I say, the additional heater, lots and lots of cost and effort has gone into this van by the previous owner. So if you'd like any more information, more than this video, then please feel free to give us a call. Thank you very much for watching.